me for a minute and you can take it to work and vlog your day.
Not really, because I can't. I'll put it back on my lap.
What's up, guys and girls? Here we are. It's Tuesday. We're on it. Andrea's on it. Looking particularly like windswept.
Yeah.
Almost look a little bit like Cousin It. Nice. Right, we'll have a lovely day. Hope it's not too stressful. Yeah, you know it, dude.
Lovely day.
Have a good day. See you later. All right, there you go. Let's get this out of the way, shall we? Oh, I think it's gonna be a wet one. Well done, MJ. Vlog life is gnarly, dude. Interesting question that was raised yesterday, though. What do you want from YouTube? I pondered the thought. Before I tell you about my ponderings of that thought though, we've got to plumb this unit from scratch. Stainless steel, which is always good fun. No measurements, so literally from scratch. Good times.
In the wise words of the Bumfunk MCs, pick a freestyler.
Might need a teeny weeny little bit off. I don't know though. Oh, let's see if it fits. I reckon it's just a little bit too much.
Oh, I don't know.
We could get really kind of mampy. I was going to say my favourite word, which is anal, about it. But it fits. It'll do. Let's just get the job done. And then I'll get back to the thought of, what do you want from YouTube?
Oh, straight in there he is. £1.
How's it going, Mr. Quiz?
Hiya.
Well, I got it wrong, didn't I? Yesterday was meant to be my mocha day, but today was going to be espresso day. But because Chris didn't turn up, I think today's a mocha day. It's very much a mocha day.
There you go. There's your calorie count right there.
Have you got a flake?
No, sorry.
Yeah. Green's been sucked. Mocha's been smashed. Stainless steel unit finished, and it's lunchtime. To have been able to show you how I did that, but if I did, I'd have to kill you. Yeah, I know, I'm wearing shorts and a winter coat. Not mental by far, eh? So, what do you want from YouTube? Now, it's probably not the best place to actually even do this little part of the video, but it's lunchtime, it's windy, and we're out here. So, yesterday afternoon, I was flitting around like I do on YouTube. It's by Nate Black. And if you're not familiar with this guy, check him out on YouTube. If you're interested in trying to make a YouTube channel work, or you're trying to like level up, guy's got some very, very valuable information that I would highly recommend you check his channel out and just see some of the advice that he has to share. But in this particular video, he was saying about what do you want from YouTube? And there was like two other questions that he posed in the video. But the what do you want from YouTube kind of, I don't know, it burnt a little thought in my brain. And it got me thinking in regards to, yeah, I understand from a viewer's point of view, it's going to be maybe an answer to a question and how to. Maybe a tech review. Maybe just good old-fashioned entertainment and escaping your world and losing yourself. Might be music. It might be something that's an entertaining short. However, this question was posed in reference to what do you want as a YouTube creator? What do you want from YouTube? And why? What are you doing it for, kind of thing? And it's interesting because I think there's going to be a lot of people that fall into different categories in this and the reasons why they do YouTube. From my point of view, the one reason I wanted to do YouTube was to almost just make a diary. Make a diary of currently when I started, the mindset that I was in, and also to gain some idea over time of how long it took to correct that mindset, break away from the old mindset, and maybe even cement in a new one. Really interesting thought is mental health, and especially depression, is always going to be different for everybody. And unfortunately, no, I don't have the answers to it. I'd love to have it in a little bottle that I could sell to everybody just to cure them of gnarly thoughts, stress, and just that mood of just not feeling worthy or maybe like, you know, just not accomplished, maybe, something like that. Cold harsh reality is, man, 5 years into YouTube, vlogging daily, and the madness that is. Still don't have the answers. And I still don't have a solid mindset that I could actually rely to or relay to anyone and say, like, this is what I did to cement my future. The good thing about that is there is no end in sight and it's forever changing, just like life. So instead of being a review channel or anything like that, with the vlog, it's one of those things. It's just ever changing, ever evolving, and hopefully constantly moving forwards. But if you're out there and you own a YouTube channel or you're trying to start a YouTube channel, it's a solid question. Ask yourself before you go too deep into the world of analytics and statistics and what thumbnails work and what you need to do to make a viral short. What do you want from YouTube? It's a heavy question. Right, well, that is another day in the book. Plenty of job done, a load of other units pushed out the door, and yeah, we started another one. So, oh, Tuesday's done. Let's go home. Do we take the red pill or the red pill? I say we take the red pill.
Do the red.
I don't know if you get that on the camera, but I sort of just looked up and thought I was tripping out or seeing stars or gonna pass out. There's like loads of flies just flying around, all crazed up, like, yeah, very bizarre, really weird. So I've been pondering the same thought all day. What do I want from YouTube? And it's kind of a mixed bag, because if I'm brutally honest, all of the stereotypical things that probably are gonna be at the forefront of most people's minds are right down the list for me. I think one of the next biggest things would to be build a sense of community and acceptance and maybe appreciation for just the everyday life. Because sometimes it's really easy to look at social media and all of the other avenues, whether it's television or movies, and see that everything has to be larger than life. And I think in the universe that we live in these days, where it's forced to us at every turn, that you have to be something or you have to go above and beyond and be the hero to your own story. Don't get me wrong, yeah, most definitely. Push hard, put in the work, dream big. But sometimes, you know, it's okay just to work that 9 to 5 and keep pushing towards those dreams gradually and hope that maybe you will succeed in the end by achieving all that you could have ever desired. Biggest thing, I think, for maybe most humans, myself included, is just finding acceptance within the world that we live in. And I think that's proving harder and harder as the time goes on and the technology advances. Because I feel like there's a huge disconnect between the humanity that we are and the humanity that we wish to be. And I don't know if that's like too out there, and I'm probably not explaining it too well. But yeah, maybe that is the key to this channel, with the fact that it's just to supply a grounding into the norm but also just to give you some hope and the thought that if I can do it, anyone can do it. And I don't even know yet because I ain't even done it, but stick on course, and like a true philosopher once said, stay the course, and we'll see what happens in the end. On that note, guys and girls, the day has come to a close. Hope you're winning, hope you're well, hope you've had a fantastic day. Shout outs go to Mr. David and Marie, and I hope you're both feeling better soon. On that note, I'll see you same time, same place tomorrow. Have a fantastic evening. Don't forget to go out and check this video out. If you're a YouTuber, I'll put a link up there, or at least a link in the description below. I'll see you same time, same place tomorrow. Have a good one. Take it easy.